Tied at the top over the Dutch Thunder, of course, as Ajax and PSV lead the charge over the Eredivisie. But who's going to come out next time around? We'll take a little look next. Today we look forward to match number 14 over Eredivisie on the shader Eredivisie, and we'll get to that in just 1 second. If you're new, where you been, smash your subscribe button, hit bang up today. Little things, Dutch football related, Bob and Rose related, recording in a car related. We've got it all here, boys, under one roof. That's right, I am in a car, and that's right, we are taking a look. And of course, the next round of matches over in the Dutchlands, and we'll get to it in a minute. A big shout out to my VIPs. Who are they? And my bloody Patreons, boys and girls. Thank you for your support behind the scenes. I do appreciate it. And of course, if you want to help check us out, check out the link down below, patreon.com/ Rover Seas. So here we go then, shall we, of course, recapping the games that did take place last time around. Now, of course, no surprise, no real surprises anyway, over in the Eredivisie. So let's take a look at it. So let's take a look at it then, shall we? Kick it all off with a recap of those last results. Start with PSV against Vitesse Arnhem. Then it was a 2-0 with PSV. I'm with a 2-1 with myself, so not too shabby there. AZ Alkmaar picked up a draw against Nijmegen. Of course, continue to defy the odds. Where are they now in the old standings? They're currently finding us in 8th in the table. Not too shabby there. Sparta Rotterdam picked up a 1-0 loss against FC 20. My boys, they're up to bloody 6. Goodness gracious me. Hercules Abner picked up a 3-1 with a Stuttgart. Warwick did lose to Ajax 5-0 in the end. I went with a 3-0 with myself. Go Ahead Eagles got found out this past weekend, a 1-0 win for Groningen on the road. Feyenoord picked up a 4-0 win over PSE Zwolle. Haddeming picked up 2-1 over Wilhelm. Trying to call it, boys, absolutely called it. And Cambo picked up a 2-1 win over Utrecht. That's a big upset there. So I got myself 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's right, I got myself 6 out of 9 there, something like that. Ajax lead the charge still. Level on points though with PSV. The goal difference, of course, massively in favour of Ajax. It's like an extra bloody point. Final are in third. 2 points adrift as well. And then, of course, they're chasing back Utrecht, Vitesse and Twente. Duking out 4-4 spot at the moment. PSV as well are going down. Stuttgart not too far away. And Sparta Rotterdam are in a bit of trouble as well. Let's take a look at that. And, of course, the prediction league. Of course, 6 would have got me third in the table. 7 Lionel L's up there with 50. Of course, 7 points. Of course, Deep Out the Greats up there also with 7. As for the leader, the overall leader, it is Nanakam. Well done to you, sir. Absolutely kicking ass and taking names. 5 points clear of the nearest and dearest. That's Deep Back the Great. Then Winky is in third. But of course, a lot of points still on the offering. So don't fear not. You've still got a chance to get involved. And if you want to get involved, use the code right here, Cutley4/Dutch. Take care, team involved. Free to enter, good bit of banter. And of course, you could become Kingpin this coming weekend. Let's take a look at that, shall we? Of course, NEC Nijmegen take on Cambuur. Of course, over in Nijmegen. And these two sides, of course, played each other 17 times since 1998. 4 wins apiece and 9 draws. Of course, Nijmegen coming to this, just 1 defeat in the past 6 games. 67% form for them right now. As for Cambuur, also 2 defeats in the past 6 games. However, winning 4 in the bounce, 67% form as well. Last round in Nijmegen was a 0-0 draw back in January 2021. Of course, Nijmegen did pick up a draw against AZ Alkmaar last round. Cambuur picked up a 2-1 win over FC Utrecht. Of course, odds on this one, 23-20 is your hosts, 5-2 is your draw on this one, 11-5 is your away win. That's Cambuur on this. Nijmegen gonna get a draw here, 1-1 for me. Point split right down the middle. Of course, those two sides are new to the Eredivisie from last season anyway. I kick it off, it'll be Sittard up against Groningen over in Fortuna Sittard. Now these two sides pushed 15 times since 1995. 2 wins for Sittard, 10 wins for Groningen, and 3 draws. Of course, Sittard coming to this by 3 defeats on the bounce. Of course, 42% form for them right now. Up against Groningen, just 1 defeat past 6 games, 10% form for them at the moment. Last time around, of course, over in Sittard was a 3-1 win for Groningen. That was back in October 2020. Of course, it was a comfortable win on the road. Meanwhile, Sittard picked up a 3-1 loss this time around, of course, against Hercules Almo just the other day. Of course, Groningen picked up a 1-1 win over Go Ahead Eagles. Odds on this one, we have Sittard 90-10 for the victory. Go Ahead Eagles, Groningen 11-8 for the victory, 23-10. So the away team is the favourites here. I'm going with Groningen. 2-1 win as they start to kick in the gear now, shall we? PSC Zwolle take on RKC Warwick. Also this coming weekend, all matches scheduled for the, well, actually between the Friday and the Sunday. I played 21 times this year, 2 6 wins as well, 7 wins of Warwick and 8 draws. Of course, as well, coming to this, 3 defeats on the bounce, 33% form for them right now, up against Warwick without a win in 3, 50% form for them. Last time out over in Zwolle was, of course, a 1-1 draw back in February 2021. In fact, the last time there was a win in this game was a 6-2 win for Zwolle back in 2019. Of course, Zwolle picked up a loss against Feyenoord last time around. Warwick got stuffed by Ajax last time around, so both size looking for a response and how. 20 out of 20 is your PEC, 12 to 5 is your away win, that's RKC, and 5 to 2 is your draw. I'm going with a 1-1 draw here. I cannot separate two sides. Also, Saturday it will be a Wilhelm Tway up against Go Ahead Eagles. Pitch of the 16 times, it's 9-3. 9 wins for Wilhelm, of course, 5 wins for Go Ahead Eagles, and 2 draws. Wilhelm will have win at least 6, in fact, they haven't won the last 7. That's the Go Ahead Eagles, just won to beat by 16, 75% form for them at the moment. Last time around, over in Wilhelm was a 2-0 win for Wilhelm, that's back in 2017. April it was. Wilhelm actually won at 4 in the bounce against Go Ahead Eagles. I haven't conceded a goal in those last 4 games as well. Wilhelm, though, of course, picked up a loss against Hedemien. Last time around, Go Ahead Eagles picked up a loss against Groningen in the Battle of the G's. 11 to 10 is your Wilhelm on this one. 12 to 5 is your away win. And 12 to 5 is also your draw. Going to go with a 1-0 win for the away team here. Go ahead, bloody Eagles. That's right. Kicking on forward, though, we do have Sparta Rotterdam. We're in a bit of trouble up against Ajax now. Of course, now these two sides play 36 times since 1993. 5 wins for Sparta, 28 wins for Ajax, and 3 draws. Of course, Sparta winning 2 and winning 2 at the last 6, 42% form for them right now. Of course, Ajax unbeaten. Haven't lost at least the last 6 games. 83% form, winning 4 and drawing 2. Of course, last time in Sparta was a 1-0 for Ajax. Of course, that was back in September 2020. It's a long time since Ajax have lost to Sparta Rotterdam. Anyway, kicking on forward, Sparta did lose their FC 20 last time around. Of course, Ajax picked up a 5-0 win over Warwick, of course, last time around. They haven't conceded a goal in the league in at least the last 3 games. It could go beyond that. Of course, busy with the Champions League as well this week. They've already secured the deal, I believe. 12-1 is your Sparta, 6-1 on is your Ajax, and 13-2. Ajax will win this one, 3-1 win, maybe conceding a goal. Maybe that's the best they can hope for in the end. FC Utrecht up against Hercules Awelo. A pleasure 36 times since 2004. 9 was Hercules, 15 was Utrecht, and 12 draws, of course. 50% form for Utrecht, winning 3 and losing 3 of the last 6 games. Up against Hercules, just 1 win in the past 4 for them, 42% form. Of course, last time out in Utrecht was a 2-0 win for Utrecht. That's back in January 2021. Of course, Utrecht did lose to Cambo last time out. Of course, Hercules Ammer picked up a 3-1 win over Fortuna Sittard, though. The odds here, though, what do we have here? 5-3 on your Utrecht on the 3-1 is your draw, 70-4 is your away win. That's Hercules Ammer. 2-0 win for the host here. Utrecht had a bit of a blip, but of course, I think they bounced back here with a 2-0 win at home. FC 20, my boys up against for Feyenoord. Of course, bit of a zinging match this one, depending on which team, which FC 20 shows up. Of course, Pleasure 56 times in 9-3, 13 wins for Enschede, 20 wins for Feyenoord, and 17 draws. Of course, 20 given this, just won the last 4 games. Of course, 58% form against Feyenoord, who've won at 6 on the bounce. They haven't lost in the last 7 across the board there, shall we? Of course, the last time out in 20 was a 2-2 draw back in February 2021. The last time anybody won this game was back in 2019 when Feyenoord picked up a 5-1 win over Enschede over in Feyenoord. Of course, 20 did beat Sparta last time around. Of course, Feyenoord did beat Zwolle last time around. And it's been back-to-back clean sheets for 20 heading into this one. 3-1 is your 20, 2017 is your final. They are your favourites. 13-5 is your draw. Back the boys here. 2-1 win for 20 on this one. First surprise package and, of course, a big win for my boys. Next, of course, I have Hedemien. They're going to be taking on PS Bloody V over in Hedemien. Now, these two sides. Pitches 58 times is 9-3, 11 wins for Hedemien, 30 wins for Feyenoord, and Eindhoven, and of course 17 draws. Of course, Hedemien competition just 1-4 for them, 42% form against Eindhoven. Of course, haven't lost in the last 4 games, 58% form for them right now. Last round in Hedemien was a 2-2 draw back in December 2020. A lot of 2-2 draws knocking around. In fact, 3 of the last 4 games have ended up all square 2-2. Of course, Hedemien comes to us on a 2-1 win over Wilhelm Tway. Of course, PSV did beat VAT's last time around. I'm going to go with after looking at the odds here. 5-1 is your Hedemien, 2-1 is your away win. That's PSV. 10-3 is your draw. Going to go with the away team here, aren't we? PSV to take it to the house. And then finally, VAT's up against AZ Alkmaar. Tricky one here to call again. Both sides compete for top honours. A pleasure of 49 times is 9-6, 50 wins to VAT, 23 wins to AZ, and 11 draws. Of course, VAT's coming to this on the back of just 2 wins. In fact, 3 wins, 3 defeats the past 6 games, 50% form. Up against AZ Alkmaar, just 1 defeat the past 4 games, 58% form for them at the moment. Of course, last time around in VAT's was a 2-1 win for VAT's Arnhem back in March 2021. In fact, the away side hasn't won this game since AZ Alkmaar beat VAT's back in 2017. Of course, VAT's did lose to PSV last time around. Of course, AZ did draw with Nijmegen last time around. 23-10 is your hosts, 23-20 is your AZ, and 12-5 is your draw. Tight here, 2-2 in the end, point split right down the middle, and I think maybe VAT's will be happier out of those two sides. Anyway, those are my picks. What about your picks? Make sure you get your picks in, of course, using the code right here, which is Cutley4StarsDutch. That is what I've got for you, folks. Be sure to give the video some love and smash your thumbs up, smash your subscribe, check the links down below on Twitter, Twitch, Facebook, and of course, Patreon as well. But until then, guys, I'll see you soon for the next one, of course, which will be start of early next week, hopefully. Anyway, but until then, guys, I'll see you soon. Until then, thumbs up, subscribe, I'm out.